Shariar Alam Minister of State for Foreign Affairs, Bangladesh, Fabrizio Hochschild, Under Secretary General, United Nations, USA, Christopher Hui, Secretary for Financial Services and Treasury, Hong Kong, Johnny C. Plate, Minister of Communication and Information Technology of Indonesia, Mucha Viada Hafid, Chairman of Commission, House of Representatives, Indonesia, Nitin Gadkari, Minister of Road, Transport and Highways, Shipping and of Micro, Small and Medium Enterprises of India, Nguyen Minh Vu, Vice Minister of Foreign Affairs, Vietnam, Sansern Samalapa, Vice Minister of Commerce, Thailand, Edwin Tong, Minister for Culture, Community and Youth, Singapore, of course, our colleagues and co-participants from the Philippines, Ramon Lopez, Secretary of the Department of Trade and Industry, Alma Rubisi Torrio, Assistant Secretary for Curriculum and Instruction, Department of Education, Luis Miguel Aboitis, CEO of Aboitis Energy Solutions, Ruth P. Briones, Chair and CEO of Green Energy Solutions, Edgar Bullizer, CEO of Paglas Group, Kevin T. Byrne, Director of the Digital Defenders, dignitaries and leaders from the business sector, friends from the international media, and the whole international community, friends, a good day to each and everyone. The COVID-19 pandemic has caused massive disruption in the global community. In terms of economic impact, the world has been plunged into one of the worst recessions in recent history. Businesses have closed, global unemployment has skyrocketed, and economic activity was brought to a seeming standstill as countries imposed preventive measures, including strict restrictions on people's physical movement and contact to prevent further transmission of the deadly virus. The global health crisis has likewise disrupted people's lives and our society's institutions. Health, education, and governance, among others, highlighting the need to transition to more digital methodologies in our attempt to adapt to society's changing demands, and in our search for alternative ways of doing work and delivering products and services to our clients. In the Philippines, the socio-economic impacts of the ongoing health crisis have been profound. For one, many months of stricter community quarantine have taken their toll on our domestic economy. According to the National Economic and Development Authority, or NEDA, Acting Secretary Carl Kendrick Chua, the pandemic and the ensuing quarantine have led to a significant contraction of 9% in the Philippine economy in the first semester. Consequently, with 75% of businesses forced to shut down, unemployment reached a high of 17.7% in May this year, with 7 million people left with no work. Nonetheless, with the gradual easing up of community quarantine, the Philippines is seeing a recovery in our domestic economy. In fact, Acting Secretary Chua recently reported that gross domestic product contraction in the third quarter has dropped to 11.5%, from 16.9% in the second quarter. In the social aspect, many sectors in the Philippines look to digital and online platforms to resume operations and provide services to the Filipino people. In the education sector, for example, primary and secondary schools, universities, and colleges adopted blended learning, a combination of modular and online learning for the current academic year. Government offices have also started providing online services to reduce, if not totally eradicate, physical transactions. The business community has refocused and re-strategized its continuity plans to adapt to the new normal. With all this, the Philippine government recognizes the importance of information and communications technologies, or ICT, in our recovery efforts, as well as in establishing a more sustainable future for every Filipino, one that would allow them to thrive during and beyond this pandemic. Therefore, the Department of Information and Communications Technology, or your DICT, as the primary policy, planning, coordinating, implementing, and administrative entity of the executive branch of the government, in charge of the national ICT development agenda, as mandated by the Philippines Republic Act 10844, has been tasked to lead the country's digital transformation efforts, guided by our department's agenda, which involves implementation of sustainable programs, projects and initiatives, and providing assistance and support to the government and private sector. The DICT aims to help establish a digital Philippines by facilitating a nationwide transition to e-government, enhancing the digital capacity of every Filipino, providing support to startups and micro, small, and medium enterprises, promoting inclusive development by promoting and supporting ICT investments in regions outside or far from urban centers, and most importantly, improving internet connectivity and cybersecurity. The transition to e-governance, online learning, and online business transactions will generate massive internet activity in the country. To support this influx, the country needs robust, quality, and reliable internet connectivity that reaches even the remotest of areas. This is why the DICT is prioritizing and fast-tracking an implementation of the National Broadband Program. This program aims to build the national fiber optic backbone that would not just augment the capacity of the current commercial ICT infrastructure, but would also connect more people to the internet, enabling every citizen to participate in the emerging digital economy. This is our vision for our country, to be interconnected and united with the help of technology. The country sees better digital connectivity and wider adoption of digital technology as driving forces towards economic recovery. The DICT sees this as foundations and prerequisites of a sustainable future for the country. Amid all these efforts, we recognize the importance of international cooperation in global recovery. We are in a global crisis, and ending it requires a global effort. The DICT therefore supports and welcomes global partnerships and cooperation for the advancement of ICT to strengthen domestic and global digital economies, and of course, for the betterment of the lives of the people, especially our most precious, strategic, and renewable resource, our next generation of citizens and leaders, our children. Thank you very much.